We set the roof. We set the roof. We set the roof on fire. We set the roof. We set the roof. We set the roof on fire. If I'm not mistaken, home team made it. 2 threes on my feet, then a pump fake.
Everyone, I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. The Steelers come into today's game looking for a way to pick up win number 10 on the season. It's the Giants going up against the Steelers. For the call, let's send you out to the broadcast booth, where we'll join our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Right at the convergence of the Three Rivers on Art Rooney Drive, we welcome you to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the New York Giants and the Pittsburgh Steelers. For Shane Vereen. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. And here's a look at the starting offense. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Throwing is Jackson. Flush to his right. Larry Donnell the target, and he's got it. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. And the starting defensive unit here for Pittsburgh.
Ryan Shazier ran so fast at his combine that many people thought someone actually ran for him. He's a linebacker who ran sub 4.4, and he uses that speed to make plays all over the field.
And he's got Will Tye complete. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Jackson now. Hitting Donnell here, the tight end right side. And he's brought down. 15 yards through the air and a first down. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
He's going to find his running back. It's complete. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll bring up second down. And the 8th play on this drive coming up.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
And down inside the 15 he goes. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Now the offense lining up first and 10.
Here we go.
Here's the former 7th-round pick, Rashawn Jennings. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Rashawn Jennings, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Giants take it right down and score on the opening drive. It's up, it's good, and the Giants have a 7-0 lead. Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
That's a good strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
On second down, it's Bell. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful, they know how to mix in the run and make sure that they keep the defense off balance and not able to just simply say, let's go get the quarterback and disrupt things.
Green's got it over the middle. And he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant, and that'll bring up second down. On your screen now, here are the offensive starters. At wideout, Antonio Brown is certainly someone that the defense always has to account for.
Without a doubt, a true number one receiver. It doesn't matter to him how defenses want to cover him. He sees it as a challenge and knows how to defeat him.
Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And he's got the AFC leader in receiving yards last year, Antonio Brown. And Antonio Brown yet to get back on his feet. Apparently shaking up that last play. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Now a first down carry by Bell. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Again, it's Bell. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and 6. And we look now at the defense for the Giants.
Janoris Jenkins combines excellent coverage ability with supreme confidence in himself. He thinks that no one is going to catch a pass in his area. Calls himself Clamp City.
He was looking to hit his running back, Le'Veon Bell, that time. And it's fourth down.
So many components go into a well-executed screen pass. You've got to sell, sell, sell. Offensive line's got to sell like they've missed blocks, and then they move out, and they're out in front of the running back. He's got to sell that he's trying to block, and then he slips out into the route. The quarterback has to sell that maybe he's trying to throw it downfield. Instead, he slips it off to the running back, and when you get one set perfectly, you have to catch the ball. And that didn't happen on that play.
So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now out come the Giants. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Stephon Tuitt, the former Notre Dame man, in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Here's Vereen, and he'll lose his yardage. Brought down at the 32. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Okay, even just being nice, the last two plays were not very good offensively. So if you're the play caller, was it the team's execution or was it strategy? If it was execution, you continue to call the game the way you're calling it. But if it's strategy, change up what you're doing and figure it out.
He was trying to get it to Benny Fowler that time. And now it's fourth down.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. With it is Brown. They find some open field here. Antonio Brown, kiss him goodbye. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Antonio Brown, 93 yards. And the Steelers are going to retake the lead. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. The return comes from Orleans Darquan. Now a hit and a loose football. Down the numbers. There he goes. And he takes it back to the house. A fumble recovery for a Steelers score. So problems here on special teams, and it results in the scoop and the score.
They talk all the time on special teams about keeping your head on a swivel, trying to see the whole field. Hard to do when things are going that fast, bodies all over the place. You're just trying to find the right guy to align yourself with. On that play, wow.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. Here comes Darquan. And he'll make it across the 20. As his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know this.
That's caught inside the 20. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and it's the Giants with a football here as we begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. This will be caught at the 2. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Victor Cruz, his second touchdown on the season. And the Giants able to get this back within a touchdown. And he'll bang that one through. Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. And Charles, this is one of those inexcusable special teams penalties, an out-of-bounds kickoff.
Pressure, pressure, pressure. Sometimes errors occur because of situations.
Now Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Yeah, I think the blitz there really disrupted the draw.
Yeah, and it's usually when you catch them in a blitz, the draw works pretty well. If you're the offensive coordinator right now, that's visor throwing time, isn't it? Because that's supposed to work in a big way.
And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. That one good for 10 yards. And that is going to set up a third and one. So 1 yard to go here on third down.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it. And boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup. And guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try to pick up a first down.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And this is caught. It's Bryant. And it's a Steeler touchdown. Mark Martavis Bryant with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Here's the Steelers' kick team as they'll boot this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he will take a knee here. So per the new rules in 2016, this will be brought out to the 25-yard line. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's got time in the pocket. He gets this one to Dwayne Harris. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Throwing is Jackson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Dwayne Harris, the intended target, and it's second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
Come on, let's go!
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Jackson now. Cruz has it over the middle. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And the 13-year man puts it through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point. So no problems converting there.
It's Marcus Wheaton now to return it. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in the touchdown looks pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
All right, here we go.
They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and 1.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They come out here in the eye.
Check 26.
They'll go again with Bell, and this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. And there on third and short, they just tried to spread the field. It worked.
And I think that the spreading of the field, the extra receiver.
And they get to him with the pressure as Roethlisberger goes down.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
On second down, Roethlisberger. 1:58 to go in this first half of play. Back to Heinz Field after this. Now Ben on third and long. And he locates Wheaton, complete. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49.
You know, when I see passes like that, I'm reminded of something you and I talked about yesterday. Big Ben was a wide receiver the first 3 years of high school, sitting behind the coach's son. And then he finally got that opportunity. I think he's made the most of it.
It's always the coach's son, isn't it? But you know where it helps him? When he looks downfield, he knows what the receivers are going to do. He actually has wide receivers' eyes when he's throwing the ball.
They'll run it with Bell. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Trying here for Bryant, and it's it. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. A great read, and it's picked off. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Giants touchdown. Well, he tried to get rid of it. Pressure was coming right in his face, and it turned out to be a bad thing.
And it's so easy to be critical of him in that spot when you have all those people bearing down on you. Probably his last thought was just get rid of the ball. Give them what they want. Unfortunately, he gave it to them too well. Picked it off, ran it back for a touchdown.
And he's able to put it through. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. On the return, here's Justin Gilbert. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too. That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? Offense staying ahead of the chains here. 2nd and 3. They'll come out in the pistol. Now Roethlisberger. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now Roethlisberger to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect. But as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. Another pistol look here. 2nd and 10 now. It's Roethlisberger.
jarred it loose. It's incomplete. He was trying to find Ladarius Green there as tight end, and that'll make it third down.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable, usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And now comes the field goal unit on. And boy, this is asking. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On fourth down, here comes the Steeler punter, Jordan Berry, to kick it away. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
Brown, the lone receiver left. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that's caught inside the 35. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 46 yards. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position, the guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front has eaten up all the blocks and just let him go to the football and make a play.
Roethlisberger with a give to Bell. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage. Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
And eventually stop just shy of the goal line, right around the 2.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this.
And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Steelers are going to take the lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Here's the Steelers' kick team as they'll boot this one away. Here comes Darqua. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. And some changes here as the D-line separates some.
Let's go! One, nine!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
And oh, look at that, a diving catch. 23 yards on the play.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball, you must have a lot of confidence or you think you're really going to fake them out. But it looks like they did exactly that.
Yeah, going deep in the playbook and a great grab on the other end. And nearly picked off there. And it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Throwing is Jackson. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field has popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. Doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Here's Brad Wing now. Remember, his first attempt was returned for a touchdown. He gets it away, and I think they'll smartly play keep away here from Brown. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They'll try and get the running game going with Bell. And he's going to be taken down shy of the five-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, not a game that you're going to go crazy about, but when you start at your own 2-yard line, any type of space is good for the offensive guys.
Yeah, you just can't go backwards from here. They did it. Now we'll see if they can keep it on schedule here on second down. And he's got some space here. And he's brought down. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
That's a football play right there. That takes me back a little bit. Toss sweep to the right. Get it to your back. Get a lot of people out in front. Control the line of scrimmage. Wide receivers blocking downfield. It almost feels like half the crowd is in.
In a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Antonio Brown yet to get back on his feet. Apparently shaking up that last play. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Jackson now. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. 15 yards through the air on a first down.
Field right, field right.
One receiver left, three to the right. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And nearly picked off there, and it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Shipped together here from the D-line. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Surveying the field. He's going to float this one deep right side. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. So still a full 10 yards to go here for the offense on third down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And Fowler's got it. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. So here we go, first and 10 now. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Here we go! 38.
Now a play fake here on first down. And incomplete on the deep ball. Larry Donnell, the one he was trying to get it to. And now it's second down. Try again with the arm here on second down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll bring up a third and one. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make someone miss in the open field.
The Giants will look to Josh Brown for the field goal try. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. And Brown able to put it through, and the drive will wind up yielding three. So a good snap, good hold, and that one's right down the middle.
Never in doubt. Just the way you used to hit them, Brandon.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
There are so many definitions of a complete back. I think most people think a guy who can block, a guy who can catch, and a guy who can run. But how about when you put it all together as a runner and you can fake people out, you can be shifty, and also run with some power and break tackles, as we just saw on that pickup.
Back now in Pittsburgh. It's Steeler football, and they have the lead as well as we begin quarter number four. They come out here in the eye. A give to Bell, and he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. He lost two there, and it's third down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
The give is to Bell. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and 8. Bell. this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie loves playing man coverage. That's his specialty. Great agility, even though he looks like one of those tall receivers he goes against week in and week out in the NFL.
And the receiver he just went toe-to-toe with there, unsuccessful, as that one knocked away. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Now a carry for the veteran. This is D'Angelo Williams. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave them with a third down and 6 to go. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
On third down, Roethlisberger. He's got his man here. It's Green. Face mask penalty, and Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make a tackle, so you end up flailing away, and your hand gets into the wrong spot.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
On second down, Roethlisberger, and incomplete. Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. Now Roethlisberger goes underneath for Bell. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They're going on fourth down. It's Roethlisberger. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. D'Angelo Williams, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
We're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it.
And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off. William Gay. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And now out come the Steelers. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created.
And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. It's JPP, 7th-year man Jason Pierre-Paul, in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Jason Pierre-Paul in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year. And 5 in the secondary now for the Giants on third down. Now Roethlisberger. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie. And New York set to
take the field.
And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Second down here after the incomplete pass. On play action, they'll throw. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. And that's caught at the 25. A big play there for the Giants. 42 yards. The last drive he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your little game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there's a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw five and still find a way to win the game in the end.
Second down following the incompletion. Jackson now. He's got time to Vereen out in the flat. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. They'll give him 8 on the play, and they're going to have a third down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Throwing is Jackson. Time for a break. And that is incomplete. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And this Steeler defense able to come up with a stop. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
They want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
And this one will go to the 28-yard line. But just 4 yards on the pickup, and that's good enough to extend the drive.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
This is Bell, and he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
But it was stopped on that play. But he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
Bryant, the lone receiver left. Now Roethlisberger to throw. He's going to and got his man complete. And he's brought down after a good game. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not.
There goes Marcus Wheaton, and he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Marcus Wheaton, his 6th touchdown of the season, and the Steelers are going to add on to their lead.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Boswell for the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now.
out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaunt. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. The Steelers are winners as we say so long from Heinz Field.